Hitler's war machine, once unstoppable, was now in the retreat. The Allies in the West and Russia in the East were squeezing the tattered remnants of the Reich in a vice-like grip. Germany's last hope lay in their wonder weapons. The V-2 rocket, a huge leap forward in the history of military technology. It was a weapon system to herald a new form of warfare. Inhuman. Faster than the speed of sound, it struck without warning. The Nazis launched over 3,000 rockets in a desperate attempt to reverse history. It was a terror weapon, pummeling Antwerp, Paris, and London. After the D-Day landings, their launch sites were overrun and pushed back out of range of England. But already, the Allies were looking to the future, to the next war. The Americans were gathering up the best of Germany's rocket scientists in the top secret operation Overcast. Many of the architects of the V-2 program had already been acquired, but not all. With Berlin encircled, Germany's last-ditch defense falling back block by block, and total defeat only days away, those scientists remaining in the city would soon be in Russian hands. My job was to make sure that didn't happen. Major General Hans von Eisenberg was negotiating in secret for safe passage for his team. Five of the V-2 program's top men. He was meeting his Russian handler at the Brandenburg Gate. This was my chance to take him out before he could seal the deal. I was prepared, focused, confident. Little did I know, it would turn out to be the most difficult mission I'd ever undertaken.
Ich weiß es nicht. Nicht wesentliche Kommunikationen sind verboten. Was war das?
Thank you.
Von Eisenberg was punctual and made no effort to hide his ugly face. Neither did his Russian contact. I had a clear shot. The slightest pressure on the trigger, and it was good night, Major General. Just a question of choosing my moment. The square was well sheltered, so there was no wind to worry about. I had to aim one notch above the target to compensate for bullet drop. I controlled my breathing to steady my aim. And then... shoot. Was dead. I was committed now. Both the Russians and Germans would know I was in play. Four to go. Intel told me my next target was Dr. Gunter Kreidel.
Now I knew where the V2 production facility was.
Thank you.
The scientists were nowhere to be found, but I kept looking, hoping to find some clue that would lead me to them. Improvising. Nothing in our intel had indicated that Schweiger was a friendly. This made him a potential asset. I had to find him. Only one problem. Berlin wasn't a ghost town anymore. The Reds had broken through the German lines, and a tank unit was heading straight for where Schweiger was being held. The Krauts were making a stand at Museum Island. I was happy to let him rot, but helping them slow the Reds was my best chance of buying some time. My plan was an audacious one. To blow up the bridge with a shot from the top of the museum, stop the tanks dead in their tracks. Then, while the Krauts and the Ivans fought it out, I could head into town and get Schweiger.
Прошлое оружие. Комиссар хочет, чтобы ее на грузовике отправили в Принцлау.
Mosin Nagant 1891-31. Beautiful. The Russians sure know how to make a sniper rifle.
Thank you.
Атакует, зубит!
Атакует!
Солдат убит!
У нас потери!
У нас потери!
Потери!
Будет!
Thank you.
the Reds and the Krauts knocking seven shades of shit out of each other back at Museum Island, I'd bought myself some time. I headed for Opernplatz, where Schweiger was being held. I'd been sent to kill him, but now I was trying to save his ass. Funny how some days turn out.
Take a look. No time. The Reds are coming. You hold them off. I'll be fine.
But I need information.
Hold them off. If you don't, we're both dead.
Yeah. The assault was over. We were safe. For now.
Thank you for the rescue. But I fear that it was... a waste of time. Wolf! As a plan. V2 rockets. Tarbin.
Tarbin? Where's that?
Not a... not a place!
What is it then? Which Tarbin? Answer me!
It's...
Intel had been wrong about Schweiger. I wondered what else we'd got wrong. Or, more importantly, what else we just didn't know. Like Tarbin. What the hell was that? And what was Wolf's plan? Whatever Wolf was planning.
Thank you.
They'd left me a Gewehr 43. ZF-4 telescopic sight. 4x magnification. Nice. No time for a test drive, though. Fritz had spotted me, as I'd known they would. Now I knew how to get Muller. One true shot from...
Yeah.
There wasn't much to go on, but it was enough. Tobin was a nerve agent, powerful and lethal. Breathe it, touch it, even look at it, and your body shut down in all sorts of gruesome ways. Wolf was the architect of the plan, a chemical weapons specialist. He was helping the Russians fill the last of Germany's V-2 rockets with this stuff. Their target, London. Those cunning red bastards would make it look like Germany's final revenge. Killing Wolf would have to wait. Nothing else mattered now. I had to stop that launch. Somewhere outside Berlin.
Thank you.
The room was a mess. The Krauts had gutted it. All the papers were taken or burnt. There had to be something here that could help. It's an old trick, but a good one. Bingo. This had to be Volf's escape plan. But before I could keep my date with that maniac, I needed to stop the V2 launch. There was nothing here to help me with that. My only chance now was the ministry building across the square. The map showed all the possible launch sites around Berlin. Only one was still operational, and in Russian-occupied territory. That had to be the place. Out immediately, praying I'd still have time.
Oh.
правильно. Видите, лучше. Протесать место. Смотрите в оба. Видите, лучше. Продолжайте, идти. Смотрите в оба. Он где-то здесь.
My last chance to take out Wolf was at the Tiergarten airstrip, 1845 hours. I didn't have much time. Stopping Wolf meant heading straight back into the heart of Berlin, with most of the city in ruins. The only location for the shot was right back where I started. I needed to get to the Brandenburg Gate. The city was on fire, the battle raging, like a vision of hell. And somewhere, in the middle of that firestorm, that bastard was gonna get in a plane and fly to safety, taking all the secrets of the rocket program to Moscow. Unless I could stop him. The Battle of Berlin ended at 8:23 the next morning, May 2nd, 1945, when Commander General Weidling submitted the surrender of German forces to General Chukov of the Red Army. Within a few days, the war ended, but already, a new war was beginning, the Cold War, and I was its first soldier.